What if that fundamental conflict between addressing the climate crisis and what's good for business suddenly disappeared? Believe it or not, that's what's happening. It's a thrilling, transformative opportunity for climate activists. It's a story so big and happening so fast that you might not be able to see it. X marks the spot. This is where the goals of the climate movement and economics align. So pay attention. It's 2019 BC, or before coronavirus. The long-term economic trends of renewables and fossil fuels look like two lines of an X. Renewables are the line going up, and fossil fuels going down. That's because the economics of renewables are closer to the economics of technology. Tech companies follow Moore's law. Computer chips get smaller, faster, and twice as cheap every 18 months to 2 years. Look at this graph of technological expansion. Computer chips keep getting smaller and faster. Exponential drop in cost. Now look at the graph of solar costs since 1977. Exponentially more efficient. Exponential drop in cost. Fossil fuels are a finite resource. The more you use, the more expensive the remaining fuel is. From 2010 to 2019, the worst performing sector in the S&P 500 was oil and gas. That was the long-term trend in 2019. Big oil's debt was starting to be judged by the biggest banks in the world to be too risky, just as continuing improvements in renewables were starting to make financial sense. We were at a precipice. You know what happens next in the story. Coronavirus pushed us off a cliff. The pandemic. Oil prices crash with the economy. The federal government then launches the CARES Act. Massive quantity of dollars are sprayed all over the economy to cushion the fall. But there's a predictable twist, if you know the lesson of widening economic inequality. Entrenched interests can use their money to wield power. Power to rig the system to benefit them. Big oil gets more bailout help than any other sector of the economy. They have a president who listens to their woes. The system is still built on fossil fuels. The necessary speed and scale of the transition to green energy still feels nearly insurmountable. But imagine if this time the goals of the climate movement and Wall Street are more aligned. It's happening. An electric car company, Tesla, has soaring stock prices. ExxonMobil, the second largest company in the world less than 10 years ago, got kicked off the S&P. This time, the best way to rebuild the economy is to address the climate crisis. That's our chance. Against all odds, it may be what our kids and their kids remember about 2020.